It doesn't matter how many times I straighten this thing out. I'm going to do a thing with my goofy ass head, and it's going to have to be straightened out again. Yeah, I've seen it in all the videos that I make. It also bothers me. And yes, I do wish that I also wasn't like this. Sorry, it's the aesthetic. What are you going to do? What's up, everybody? My name is Sam, and this is the Internet Where Things Happen. And today, I keep on doing this to myself, and I hate it. Well, there's got to be a part of me that enjoys it a little bit, because I keep doing it. Existence is pain. We all got to die someday. Today, I wanted to kind of talk to you about one of my favorite shows ever. Such a good show. And if you've been paying attention to Netflix and various other news things at the moment, you'll know about Avatar: The Last Airbender. But I'm not just going to talk about it because it's boring, but what I'm going to do is, we need some hot sauce. It's this guy. Bravado Spice Company, Black Garlic, Carolina Reaper Hot Sauce. This is apparently 5 ounces of the good stuff. Ooh, it's liquidy. You like that? Is it doing anything for you? Is it some asthma? Whoa, okay. Woo. Woo, woo, woo. Yeah, I realized I didn't have any delivery methods for hot sauce. Did I just blow on the hot sauce? The hell? Yeah, I realized I didn't have any delivery methods for hot sauce, so I grabbed a club cracker. Oh, well, not that one. I'm just gonna pour some of this on here. Ooh, that's thick. Oh, that is so much. That was way less viscous than I wanted it to be. Well, we're not bitching out now. Can't do it. Have to do it. Unless. No. You know what? Oh, why did I do that? Oh, it was a mistake. Okay. So, if you look at Avatar: The Last Airbender, you see a kid show. It's a cartoon, you know, we all suffer adults, whatever. But. What I present to you is that Avatar: The Last Airbender is not just a kid's show. Oh, fuck me. Why are you? I'm here to tell you that while it is a show presented for kids, it doesn't treat kids like they're stupid, because they're not. Kids are way smarter than people give them credit for, and this show gives them credit for it. And so, well, yes, it's, you know, it's funny, and it's like, it's appropriate for children. Like, there's so much to love about it. It's on the outside of my lips. What the hell, man? Why is this a thing? It's because I drank it. I shouldn't have drank it. My hubris. I feel like the show does basically everything right as far as, like, the storytelling and the way it does tropes and things like that. Because it's got a lot of characters, a lot of central characters, and And they all, like, serve a purpose. Like, I think one of my favorite things is Sokka, one of the characters in the show, is one of the traveling companions. He's very much a comic relief character. He's, like, the funny guy. You're supposed to laugh at Sokka, ha ha ha. But, like, they don't make him useless. And, like, first time you meet him, you know that, like, he serves a purpose. He's there for a reason. He is surprisingly smart, even though he's a comic relief character, and they don't treat any of their characters like any of their main characters like they are garbage. They're all important, and they all serve a purpose, and they're all great in their own way. If you don't know what Avatar is, of course, it's on Netflix. It was our number one show in the U.S. for a few weeks. I think it's been unseated at this point, but it was there for a while. And it's just this, it's a show about this kid who is, he reincarnated, he's like called the Avatar. And, that was very close. He was this master of all the elements, and he's supposed to save the world. And he ran away from his destiny when he was young, and he got trapped in this ice, and for 100 years, and now he's back. And he travels around the world trying to learn how to airbend so we can stop this giant war when the Fire Nation attacked. You know the meme. And Aang, who is the main character, he's the titular avatar. He's a kid with all this, like, weight and responsibility, and he acts like a kid because he is one, but, like, he's just also, like, really old, and he's got all this power and responsibility. And he plays a very good, reluctant hero. Katara is a great, like, female character. She's very, like, nice and responsible and, like, loving and, like, you know, really wants to see the team do well and, like, is nice, but, like, she knows, like, she can fucking, like, kick some ass too, and that's really good. Toph is just this, like, sarcastic, smarmy little girl, blind girl who could earthbend, and she's great. Zuko is just, like, a really awesome, like, one, like, he's a villain, and on the surface, he appears like he's very one track. But he's not. He's got so much underneath the surface to love about him and his plight. And he's a villain, but he's played as sympathetic, and you actually do feel sympathy for him, and it's very good. His uncle Iroh is maybe my favorite character, and I would trade Iroh for literally no other character in fiction because he's wonderful. Anyway, the story is really good. I think my favorite thing about the story is that my favorite thing about the story is that there aren't really any wasted episodes. Even things you would consider filler are, like, wasted. Filler is a term that's been used for a long time to mean, like, an episode that does nothing to advance the story. But I also think that filler should be that it does nothing to advance the character development as well. And every single episode either advances the story in some way or advances a character in some way. And even the one episode, it's called The Divide, even the one episode that you could argue doesn't do either is still good. You know what I mean? And so they don't waste any time. It's all great all the way through. All of these, they have a bunch of character arcs that pay off. If I could use Game of Thrones as an example, there's a very specific character in Game of Thrones that goes through this, like, redemption arc, and it's completely squandered by the end of the series. But, like, this show is a kid's show that manages to do complex dynamic relationships complex villains, complex motivations. It manages to show the black and white of fucking war. Ooh, wow, that hurt to say. It manages to show that the black and white of war isn't necessarily black and white. There's lots of gray on either side, even though you're supposed to be on this group side. You're supposed to root for this side of the thing. Like, it kind of shows you that they're kind of shitty too in the midst of fucking war. Oh, I feel it right here. Like, the heat is kind of dispersing, but like, I feel it in my chest, my lips still. And it's like less heat and more discomfort at this point. And yeah, there's like some like romantic stuff that's in there, but like it earns it and it makes sense and it feels like it pays off in a way that makes sense. And that's really great. And it's just like a really good show. It's on the fuck. You should watch it. You should watch it. I always think I'll take notes and write it down, but like it won't help. It won't do anything because my brain turns off. I don't even remember what the hell I said. I really don't. I don't remember any of what I just said. Heat's fine now. It hurts. It hurts here. Oh yeah, it's on Netflix. The three seasons of it are on Netflix. Go watch it. Like, it's so good. If you didn't get a chance to watch it when you were younger, like I did, or you haven't watched it as an adult, just go watch it. Watch it with your family. Watch it with somebody you care about. Watch it with your kids. If you have kids, and you all enjoy it. It's a thing. Like, I know people, oh, wow. I felt a pork big deep deep. That's all, folks. Watch it with your kids. I know a lot of parents like look for things to watch with their kids that don't annoy them to no end. This is such a great show. It's such an engaging show. The action scenes are like, the fights are great because it's all about like bending and like, elements and things like that. And the choreography, the fight choreography in this animated show is great. And so you should really, God, I'm sweating. You should really like get a lot out of it. There's like one particular, there's like, especially towards the end of the show, like the fight scenes are incredible. So please, you know, just go watch it. You do it to yourself. Owe it to yourself to watch Avatar, The Last Airbender. Hi, hello, it's me, your friend Sam. This Sam's past that you're watching currently, but also your past, it doesn't matter. I am currently editing the video that you are watching right now, and it reminded me that I should warn you that the movie, the live action movie by M. Night Shyamalan that's also on Netflix, is a disaster and you should not watch it. I understand that by telling you not to watch it, your curiosity is piqued and you think that maybe I should watch it, but like, it's not even fun bad. Like, there's nothing about it that's redeemable in any way. Like, they pronounce things wrong. Like, it's just wrong. It's a bad movie. You won't have fun watching it. And, you know, I'm just here to render advice. You're watching this probably grown enough to make your own decisions. Do what you want. I'm just saying it's probably for the best. Anyway, back to whatever is happening. I give Avatar 5 peppers out of 5 peppers. It's so good. I give this hot sauce. I'm going to give the hot sauce 4 out of 5 peppers because it is very hot. And I still feel it on my lips, on the outside of my lips. But it actually tastes not bad. It's just hot. I honestly think it's because I drank it. But literally, like, it's giving me some discomfort, like, literally right in this area of my torso, my chest, my stomach. So, yeah, that's about all I got. I need this. Oh no, how did it do that? Oh, it's in there. Oh God. I gotta go deal with this. Bye. Oh God, that sucks. Oh my God. Why? Oh.
Fuck me. My fucking eye. Why? God damn it. Why? Oh, shit. Fuck.